So nobody melted today.
Yeah, and, we were saying that.
So today was our 60th anniversary of the initial event, which was the original. They called it the Weenie Roast. As it went forward, it started to diminish in size and duration. So I was asked to come on board in 99 to get things going. So I filed the permits that they couldn't get. And then in 2000, I rolled it into what would become the annual children's hot dog party and car show at the beach.
Right. Now, unlike other car shows, this wasn't one of those shows that's, you know, when you go to Eisenhower Park or you go out to Patchogue and everybody knows about it. This was always its own little enclave, its own little kind of personal deal. This was a neighborhood event.
I started it that there were a lot of nice cars in the neighborhood.
Oh, yeah. Whitestone always did, yeah.
And so I said, you know what? I said, let me get the guys together. And cars is the best common denominator. I mean, every car guys love car guys. So it started to grow. And then I made friends with the right people. Marty Schorr became a good friend now. Mm-hmm. And I know you had Marty on earlier. Mm-hmm. And then I started to go after different cars and got introduced based on the credibility of people that, you know, you can drop name, right. Name drop. And then
name dropping is
Marty... Fun. Then Marty was approached by Alana Scher from Hot Rod Magazine coming east and doing some type of how do guys in the East Coast, what do they do with their cars? And yeah. Marty, are you available to meet? And Marty said, no, you're not going to meet me. You're going to meet Bill Giaccio.
Yeah.
So Alana came east and we spent a couple of days together and I took her around and I said... And she said, well, what's the deal on the East Coast? I said, we store our cars one garage at a time, one 10 by 20. Yeah. And we went around. And then Alana was like what we were doing. And in the 50th anniversary of Hot Rod Magazine, actually, she proclaimed the Malba Car Show to be one of the top 10 spots you have to go see if you go east.
Absolutely, yeah.
So it was really nice. And the show then just took legs. And today I was very fortunate. You know, we got Gary DeBrush here. Mm-hmm. And... you know, Gary, we know, did all of the motion cars back in the day, the bodywork, the paint schemes, and Marty with the PR. And, you know, we all hung their posters in our bedrooms and, you know.
And our garages.
Garages.
Yeah.
And then Howard Kroplick, mm-hmm. That's a gentleman with the Alco 6, the Black Beast.
We heard him blast by just before.
I was chasing Howard down for 6 years to get the car.
Yeah.
And Howard was always a big football fan and an opening day Jet fan. So this year when the NFL schedule came out, I looked at the schedule and I saw that the Jets weren't playing. And I said, you know, and I called him, I told him, I emailed him. He said, you're good. He said,
yeah.
So he said, you know what, Bill? He said, the calendar's clear. So we got the Black Beast, the Alco 6 here today, which we presented it with the Commodore's Award.
Very nice.
Which is the trophy that I called when you were going out with the wife, the bride, you know, the girlfriend, and you would circle back around the block. She said, what are you doing? I said, you know, you see a car in the driveway?
Right.
He said, the car that grabs your attention. Well, of course, the Alco 6 grabs your attention.
But, I could not.
But, you know, this is my swan song here today, 20 years. But over the years, you're naming some of the Commodore cars we had. They had Glenn Spielberg in the Co-Motion Corvette was here, mm-hmm. took a trophy. In fact, Glenn was invited today, but being a real car fanatic myself, I told Glenn, I said, Glenn, we can't have all the original markings on the car. Don't expose it to the weather. And Glenn felt bad, but he understood. So, Glenn, I know if you're out there, we appreciate all your efforts. Mm-hmm. So we had some tremendous cars here. Mike Manning, with everything that Mike did. We had the Batmobile here 1 year, Commodore Award winner.
Yeah.
We had
the Dragula
here another year, Commodore Award.
I worked on both of those.
And then we've had some real eclectic cars over the years. I had Ricky Minetta's one of the 12
phase three.
That was another.
Yeah.
I mean, so...
And the ice cream truck. Don't forget the good humor truck.
The ice cream truck.
God bless my wife, Lorraine, who's looking down on us. She, Lorraine
absolutely.
Was... She, when I had the one of the 12, when I had Ricky's phase three here, she said, Bill, she said, at the end of the show, she said, I don't know if you... everybody really gets an idea, gets a handle on what that was about. She said, I know you do, but she said, you know, you, I said, you know what, Rain? I said, you know, you could be right.
Yeah.
I said, next year, I'm going to have the universal appealing vehicle. And we had the good humor truck.
Ice cream truck, yes. Of course.
Yeah. And unfortunately, Lorraine succumbed to cancer during the year. And I came back as the champion. And in Lorraine's honor, I gave away 967 pieces of ice cream out of that truck.
Right.
That we dry iced it up. And my buddy Joe was the good humor man.
And the uniform stood right out there at the corner. Yeah.
But
fantastic.
I want to thank you two gentlemen. And then Chris Switzer also. Mm-hmm. I mean, you've been a big part of this over the years. You gave me the You give me exposure. You make me into somebody I'm not, which is. But you know, I'm a regular car guy. I'm a car guy like the rest of us.
Yeah.
And what are my plans for the future? You know, I don't know. But you know what? I'm entitled now to bring my beach chair and hang out with you guys and tailgate out of there.
That sounds good. Maybe next year he could be in the booth.
And I was going to say, you could hang out with Bill. Where else can you crack a bottle of Seagram 7 with a 1973 seal on it still? that was at your race party.
So we'll be after today. We'll kick back and.
What's the future of the show? Where's it going to go now? What's projecting forward?
The future of the show is that they say. They don't know if they can continue it. But you know what? This was always intended to be about the children. You got to remember, when I started this event, the kids were 7 years old.
Now they're married.
They're married. They're moving back to the neighborhood. So you know what? Somebody else's turn. Let's pass the baton.
Right.
You know? I mean, I don't want to be chairman emeritus or any of that. I mean, but if they ask me, Bill, what direction? I have a mailing list. I got the vendors, and we know the right people.
Yes,
right.
There you go. Your wisdom will always be.
But I thank you for having me on,
and thank you for having us be a part of this.
We appreciate it
that we have done it. In fact, that's how when Marty was coming up, and he sent me an email because we'd had him on the radio show and said, hey, you know, you're going to Malba. And I'm like, to what? And that's when I had known Joe already and met Joe and said, hey, Joe, what's Malba? He goes, what, are you kidding me? I said, yeah, he's telling me to talk to some guy named Bill. And Joe says, boy, no, only one guy named Bill. He was an altar boy I was with. So anyway, we put the pieces together, and that's what formed the union. And it's been, thank all you guys for, again, things come together, Gary, from different ways sometimes, from different sides. Sometimes you don't see it happening, and it just materializes.
Well, somebody told me about this show last year, and I didn't know anything about it. And then last week, I get a phone call from two Corvette guys that want to get their car striped, and they got to get it done before this show. Yesterday, I striped two of the cars that are out here.
Oh, okay.
And so they said, you got to come down to the show. You got to come down. So here I am.
Are they like COA guys that are out there?
Like what?
Like that's a light Long Island Corvette Owners Association.
No, actually, these
like
are local guys. Okay, right from here. Right. Excellent. From this neighborhood.
But you know what's funny with Gary? I asked Gary today. I said, so Gary, I said, I'm sure now you got a staff that picked up on your talent that's doing the way you did it. He said, Bill, I'm the guy.
It's like your staff, Bill.
I'm still the guy. Yeah, we're still the guys, Gary.
Just me. Now, though, that I'm in this shop, I do get some help from the guys that are in there.
That's cool.
You know, if I want something sanded, they'll sand it for me.
Oh, nice.
Or if they know that I'm going to paint the motorcycle, I'll turn around and they prime the car, so they'll prime the motorcycle parts for me.
Great.
So they do that. The artwork I still have to do, but I do get a lot of help from the guys in
the
shop.
Well, that's good. This way you get to do what you do.
Right.
And they can fill the rest. That's fantastic.
Now I have a downdraft booth to work into.
Oh, man.
Nice. All these years, I didn't have one.
Right.
I have a downdraft booth to work in.
Excellent.
So that's
excellent.
Nice.
You know, there's one disclaimer I just have to get out there to the folks that couldn't make it today. Mm-hmm. You know, we had the show scheduled, and then we always have a rain date. We never had to exercise the rain date. This was one of those weeks where you couldn't predict the weather because it was so unpredictable.
Right.
But we were so committed with infrastructure and having guests and people coming in from out of town in special cars, Marty and Howard, that we had to go forward.
Yeah.
And so we found out today that collector cars don't melt in the weather. And did we start a new trend, and maybe that, you know what, you could still go forward with some of these events?
Sure.
We don't know. But you know what, to the guys out there that couldn't make it, We went forward because the weather was good enough here, and like 52 cars is successful in anybody's eyes. And
yeah, that's no joke.
And it might be another new, another trendy starter. We did a first live remote from here.
Appreciate that.
So that's you're making Motor Mouth Radio history for us as well, Bill, and we appreciate it.
It's drizzling, but it's not windy.
Yeah. Right.
Thank God.
So
yeah.
That's easy.
Well, back in the day, you used to only have like a few, you know, it was never that big a show in the beginning.
No, in fact, the initial show in 2000 was 40 cars.
Oh, okay. So we kind of beat that today.
In the rain.
Yeah.
Right.
You know, but it's good seeing a lot of friendly faces. I saw Dougie walking around.
Yeah.
And
there he is.
You know, and Dougie and I hit it off right from the beginning. It's that car guy common denominator, you know?
Right.
You know, so it's good seeing old friends.
Yes.
Thank you again.
Bill, thank you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you
for the day. For the event, like I said, without you doing the hard work and diligence, and the rest of your crew, because you do have a lot of guys that help out, all great fellas and women, that help out. So we appreciate that very greatly. And maybe we're on to a thing here, Joe. I don't know. Maybe we're going to do a show from the UD next.
I think the cable will reach there, right?
I don't know. They may put wrenches in our hands or something and say, fix this.
Just not on a Saturday, that's all.
Yeah, right.
It would have to be during the week.
Busy day, excellent. That's excellent. So we are going to be, we're getting to the end of the rope here. We only have a few minutes. Doug, did you want to jump on and say hi?
Just came by to say hello to you guys.
All right.
Hey, Doug. How are you?
How you doing?
Great show, man.
Thank you, Doug.
Thank
you.
Really
thanks,
Pete.
No. Yeah. Thanks, Doug.
Bang.
I love the sound effects from the back. We have it's better than music.
That's the beast.
That is the beast again?
Yeah.
Okay. No kid.
Yeah.
Oh, very cool. Excellent.
Nice.
Excellent. All right. We're gonna.
We better start packing all the stuff. I'm gonna get in the other end and start rolling up the cord.
You're gonna have to because you got to go back to Garden City with it.
And
then Kim can continue on. So that's it. We only have a few minutes left. I hear our outro music. We are done. For Joe D, Ray Guarino,
he's in jacket. What's your hurry?
Billy G, Gary Local Brush. We got Dougie, Johnny. We got Sean. We got everybody here. We'll be back next week live from the studio on more Motor Mouth Radio. Keep what you got. Listen to Kim, and we'll see you next week
on WHPC.